Hello everyone, I am Ketan from Amexio team. In this video, we are going to see how to define a models in Amexio Canvas. So let's get started. For the demo purpose, we are going to define one employee model which consists of a ID, first name, last name, gender ID, phone as string. Then we are going to add a age as a number and email, department, country ID and state ID as a string. Once you log into the Amexio Canvas, you will require to go to the model builder and click on new, add the name for the model. So I'm going to add a name as an employee and add a description, some description over here. My model has been saved. Now you need to add a fields. So I'm going to select a fields as a primitive data type and select a different data types as per my requirement. So when you are going to define a fields, it can be a primitive or object. Let's suppose if you want to have one kind of the models into the another model, you'll require to select an object. In that way, you can select another object which is defined previously. We are going to cover that particular scenario once our employee model has been defined. I have added an ID, first name, last name. Now let me add a gender ID with a data type as a string. Now I will add a phone as also as a string. Then I'll add an age as an integer data type. I am going to add few more fields like department, country and state. Let me add a country and state as well now. Once your model definition is done, you can go to the task details and see the task associated to this particular model. So you can go to the task details screen and see the task for that particular model has been completed. Now you can see the source code for that one. You can see the employee model TS file has been created with all the attributes which are defined and associated getters and setters method into that. Now let me define one more model which consists of another model. So we are going to give the model name as a response pin. Which consists of a primitive type as boolean. Let's say it's a success, true or false, like that. Then we'll have a string data type for a message. And we'll add one more object into this one, that is the employee, which can be a list of employees. Now my response bin has been saved. You can go to the task detail and check the status for that. It's completed successfully. You can go to the code explorer and see the code for that. Here you can see the response bin consists of an employee, message and success, where employee is a list of, that is the array. So in this video, we have seen how to define a different models using a model builder UI in Amexio Canvas. Next video, we are going to see how to define a service, how to define a different services. Thank you and have a nice day.